and welcome to CEO TV. I'm Sarah Freemark, coming to you from Yonge and Dundas Square in downtown Toronto. Now, politics is serious business, unless you're our next guest. He's both poked fun at politicians and used his skill as a PR executive to rewrite the story of his own career. CEO TV reporter Christine Wong has more.
Politics has always been fodder for great comedy. Witness the success of political shows like The Daily Show and The Colbert Report. But politics have also provided one Toronto PR executive with a prize and a publishing deal.
Hey, Sammy.
Hi, Terry.
Bern and Anna, we should give them a call.
Meet Terry Follis. Most of his clients know him as the president of Thornley Follis, an award-winning PR firm that manages the corporate message for big guns like Travelocity and GM Canada. But for his entire life, Follis has harbored a secret identity. Behind his Clark Kent glasses and button-down facade, another personality was lurking underneath, an alter ego who is... funny?
3, 2, 1...
You can't do that.
You can't do that.
Okay, that'll be a good one for the Christmas party. Now, don't make me laugh, Sammy.
Beneath his business-like exterior beats the heart of a humor writer. After years of writing speeches and marketing campaigns for corporate clients, Follis finally sat down to write a short story, then turned it into a full novel. After 10 months of writing between running a business and running his family, the book was finally finished.
The notion was to plunk down in the middle of Parliament Hill the least likely character ever to arrive in the House of Commons, and just to sort of track that story.
Follis has government as well as corporate clients, and he himself once spent time working in the political trenches for Jean Chrétien, so he wrote what he knew. A classic political satire, The Best Laid Plans follows the unlikely pairing of a Parliament Hill exile and a sham election candidate.
The lounge next to the dining room is populated with 30-year-old couches and chairs sporting strangely hued upholstery from the Shades of Internal Organs collection.
But once a book is written, every writer needs readers.
So I sent the manuscript out to a number of agents and waited and did some follow-up and really wasn't successful in getting much of a reaction.
Follis sent the book to some small publishing houses but still got nowhere. Summoning his entrepreneurial instincts, he forked over $4,000 of his own money to a do-it-yourself publishing outfit. He also made a podcast of the book that generated buzz with 2,000 subscribers around the world. And then came the bombshell.
Well, it was complete shock. I was in Montreal on business that day. I just finished doing a presentation. I knew that the shortlist was being announced at 10:30 that morning.
The self-published book by the agentless first-time writer got nominated for Canada's biggest award for humor writing, the Leacock Medal. And Follis won, beating out such heavyweights as Douglas Copeland of Generation X fame. Follis is brand new to writing humor, but he's definitely getting the last laugh.
I think it's probably the closest thing to having a stroke, is how I felt, because I was unable to speak briefly, and I felt paralyzed, and it was quite a shock. I had to get up and leave the room for a while, because I was pretty well overcome.
The inexperienced author pocketed the $10,000 prize, yet still had no publishing deal. Here he is at a Leacock Awards meet and greet. But remember all those agents who took a pass on this neophyte author? Well, after the Leacock win, one of them had a change of heart.
The book is funny, it's true, and it's important.
Beverly Slopin turned Follis down the first time, but now she's taken him on as her newest client. And she's getting a lot of calls from foreign publishers. They're as intrigued by Follis's own story as they are by the story he wrote.
He is the innocent in the shark-infested pool of publishing, and he won. And so everybody in the international publishing industry has been cheering this.
And Follis just landed a big-name publishing deal here at home. McClelland and Stewart will take the book to its presses this fall. But Follis isn't leaving the business world behind. In fact, he says crafting corporate messages has actually helped him in his own writing.
When I'm writing for a CEO, a speech, I need to get inside his or her head, learn their voice, and write in their character. which is almost identical to what one does when writing a novel and creating a new character.
Fallis is a living example that it's never too late to make your fairy tale come true. The only catch is, you just might have to write and publish it yourself. For CEO TV, I'm Christine Wong.